Over the years, families hailing along River Nyamamvwa Valley, especially in the areas of Kanyangeya Cell, have been displaced. The internally displaced persons, or IDPs, living in Muhocha Resettlement Camp in Kasese District are grappling with lack of basic needs. During the visit, authorities embarked on supplying a number of scholastic materials to students. This included mathematical sets ahead of the primary living examinations.
I wish you success through you to the whole class, that please God will be there for us.
A number of school heads whose schools have been threatened and affected by the floods have explained how this has crippled the education quality.
Our children would be doing well, but the challenge is they come from an environment which has been affected by floods, and most of the parents are still staying in Muhocha camp where they have been displaced by River Nyamwamba, and most of our children are lacking the necessary requirements, especially scholastic materials, school uniform, lunch.
The parents do not know the dates of birth for their children, which is a shame. Two, they do not want to give us their name, whereby they provide their IDs, either as a photocopy, or if he comes himself or herself, we just copy the name from the ID. As if that is not enough, then we've got a challenge of paying school dues.
School heads have challenged parents to engage in the well-being of their children while at school. They have asked them to provide meals and scholastic materials to the learners. In September, Rehma Ariema, the chairperson Muhocha IDP camp, asked the government to empower and avail land for the internally displaced persons to economically empower themselves.
It's now a year down the road. We don't know where the land is. We don't know when are we going to be settled. But we hear, say, even the RDC of Kasese District came here and assured my people that the land is there. They're going to be settled.
The silting program started in upper part. The silting program phase one started in upper part. So we have hope that having restored the riverbanks and the silting the stream, then the problem will be solved. But however much we solve the problem, most of the structures are put down.
As primary 7 candidates prepare for their final exams tomorrow, persistent rains accompanied by bad roads are anticipated to disrupt the exercise in Bududa. These worries were expressed by the headteachers and learners during a briefing of primary 7 candidates in Bududa today. According to Dominic Buayo, the chairperson of Bududa Headteachers Association and the headteacher of Bumwale Primary School, there are many schools that are inaccessible and in hard-to-reach areas, something that may disrupt movement of the exams.
We are really worried. We don't know whether, if it rains like this, how the supervisors, implicators, and then the disputers are going to move with exams.
Candidates who spoke to us say they are worried about the rains but committed and determined to reach their centers on time.
We are very worried because the rain is there and it may stop us from doing our primary living examination. And yet this examination is going to mark the end of our primary level. So with that, we pray to the Almighty that He help us so that the rain will not rain tomorrow.
We shall make sure that even if it rains too much, we shall attend our exams. We shall have umbrellas if it rains too much.
If it rains, we shall carry gumboots. We shall put on gumboots and we carry umbrellas. And we shall make sure that we do our final exams.
Bududa District registered a total of 3,022 primary 7 candidates with 1,246 males and 1,776 females who are going to sit for the 2023 primary living examinations. This will be conducted in the 53 primary school sitting centers throughout the district. Story by Samuel Amanyire and Andrew Nahaboya for the news.